The Aston Martin Valkyrie, technically designed by one of the most successful race car design engineer in modern automotive motorsport. And that is Adrian Newey, Red Bull Racing's chief designer for the Formula One program. This car is an Aston Martin and Red Bull Advanced Technologies collaboration to build what they see as the ultimate hypercar. Newey said that it would be designed around philosophy used on a Formula One race car. With that philosophy, immediately the difference is obvious between this car and other supercars. Just look at the front end. It looks to be entirely devoid of any form of cooling. Even the brake ducts can't be seen, just like on Formula Racing or sports prototypes, although on those cars the brake ducts are quite prevalent. Instead, it opens up purely for aerodynamic enhancement. Type of cars that share similar traits would be road legal track cars, for example, like the Freestream Caparo T1. The targets to build the ultimate hypercar basically is to achieve 1-to-1 power to weight ratio on high downforce with all the drama and instant response of a highly strong, emotion evoking, soul stirring, naturally aspirated V12 engine. 1-to-1 power to weight ratio generally indicates an extreme interpretation of maximum power or minimum weight. To help achieve this power to weight ratio is a naturally aspirated 6.5 liter 65 degree V12 with a maximum power of 1000 brake horsepower at 10,500 rpm and 740 newton meters of torque at 7000 rpm by Cosworth. An additional 160 brake horsepower and 280 newton meters of torque is by a Rimac and integral powertrain battery electric system, bringing a total power output of 1,160 brake horsepower with a combined peak torque of 900 newton meters, all emission compliant. Furthermore, the engine is a full stress member rearward of the chassis to reduce weight. Although very light and efficient in reducing weight, the usual problem with this setup is that the engine is rigidly mounted to the chassis. Engine vibrations will directly translate to the chassis, and it's even worse if it's made out of carbon fiber. Because carbon fiber is a strong material, it will be made thinner, so vibrations will be amplified compared to a chassis with more mass. The clever bit here in using this setup is doing it with a V12 engine. The V12 engine configuration has the least amount of vibrations amongst general engine configurations, so this shouldn't be an issue. The part where it takes advantage of Formula One philosophy is downforce. It applies the Y250-like vortex off the inner front wing, controlling front wheel wake that could have an adverse effect on ground effect downforce, and a diffuser that takes center stage. The front wing seems to generate a vortex similar to what Formula One cars have, and that is the Y250 vortex. It will spiral from the middle section underneath towards the side. It may not influence airflow downwards like on a Formula One car, where the Y250 vortex also drag air downwards towards the barge boards, because the top front section of the Valkyrie is covered. This vortex is used to move air away from the floor for even more downforce, while allowing the vehicle to maintain general ground clearance that would pass for a road car. The outer wing also looks to be shaped around generating another vortex that spirals the opposite directions to the inner wing's vortex and sweep the inner wheel wake away from heading towards the main floor. This will clean up airflow underneath for improved ground effect downforce. What's interesting is those large downward blades hanging off the upper section. It looks to be a barrier to prevent front wheel turbulence in disrupting this vortex. It may also act as a surface for the vortex to attach itself in the context of the Coanda effect, to prevent vortex from entering the diffuser and also to guide the vortex towards its intended target. What this can do is get the vortex to go around the main body, such as the high-mounted radiator side pod intake and diffuser skirts, creating a clear path for the vortex to maintain its energy, clearing air outwards away from the floor. The diffuser begins right underneath the engine cooling intake, and it's very substantial in the space it opens up. It also spots what looks like those classic side skirts from the ground effect era of Formula One cars of the late 70s, but with added much more contemporary footplate design. The edge of the car spots three curved footplate per side, six altogether, one in the front wing, side skirts, and interestingly, rear diffuser. Because airflow inwards of the car's floor, as it is where ground effect generates a lot of negative pressure, these curved footplates create a vortex from this airflow path inwards and act like a barrier to slow down this airflow, improving ground effect downforce. These slots look to push down the vortex towards the ground and further seal rearward section of the floor in front of the rear wheel. Then we come to the diffuser. It is substantial in the space it takes up. The entire rear section is dominated by it, that even the exhaust system of the Valkyrie has to make way. It also spots a semi-cylinder footplate instead of what is normally seen used on a diffuser, which is a flat one. Again, all that air moving inwards towards the diffuser's negative pressure area would create a vortex here and help reduce air moving inside the diffuser. Aston Martin says the opening clamp above the front suspension complements the front wing in generating even more front downforce. So it's not an aesthetic design, but it seems to bring about its own aesthetic qualities. To maximize interior space, the seats are mounted directly to the tub, with occupants adopting a reclined feed-up position reminiscent of today's Formula One and Le Mans prototype race cars, ensuring driver and passenger are extremely safe, perfectly supported, and feel completely at one with the car. This also allows a lower roofline that would improve aerodynamics. What is also unique about the Valkyrie's design is how technical it is below the waistline, where it does not compromise to generate as much aerodynamic performance as possible and bears absolutely no hint at styling, yet somehow the organics makes for a significant contribution to its looks, complementing the top section that the designers had worked on. Just when the car is designed with ultimate in mind, Aston Martin has the AMR track pack for the Valkyrie to take it even further. It is interchangeable with the road car's parts, transforming it to be more track focused. Included in this track pack is even lighter brakes made out of titanium, assuming this is the caliper, a clamp that has even more aggressive aerodynamic setup with larger air vents and added turning vanes, a lower, more track-focused active suspension setup, aero disc covers for the wheels, and lightweight magnesium wheels. The track pack is said to reduce lap times by 8% depending on track layout.
So you know about the car, of course, so it's an active suspension car, active aero, active damping.
The active suspension is crucial for the Valkyrie to adapt to both low speed, low downforce, and high-speed, high-downforce loads subjected to the suspension. This allows for a more compliant ride from low speeds to high speeds.
Yeah. Oh, it's good. It's a lot of fun. It's a work in progress, but it's amazing. I mean, to have this on the road, it's gonna be insane.
Was it?
Good. It's good, like the feeling on the entry.
It's good, right?
It's quite sharp.
Fourth gear already?
Nice.
Well, for me, it was the first time driving the Aston Martin Valkyrie. So, it's of course incredible to get a first like taste of it. So, of course, very happy with it. Yeah, so of course, it's still under development phase, but I think you can already feel the basics of the car, which, of course, compared to a normal road car, are pretty different, I would say. So, the Valkyrie, I mean, it's incredible. The downforce you have on the car as well, it just looks super aggressive, and it was a lot of fun out there.
We're here in Silverstone, very cold Silverstone, driving the Aston Martin Valkyrie for the first time. Very exciting and good experience. Looks really cool. I think the first thing that I got was the visual aspect of it. I think, especially on the inside as well, you can tell it really feels like a racing car, the way that the monocoque kind of covers you and you feel really safe inside. You sit really low down, you got good visibility, and it just looks awesome. obviously it's still ongoing, the car, and it's still developing. So it's still got a bit to go, but already now it feels very, very good. I felt like, especially the balance between the corners. It was light. It felt sharp. Good on the brakes. So yeah, all good. It really shows Red Bull branching out. I think Aston Martin as well being very welcome to the idea that a Formula One team working with a car manufacturer, with Adrian's help and everything like that. I think it's very exciting to get that kind of technology that we have at the racetrack and bring it onto the road.